Okay, welcome everyone. This is Victor's Vegan 360, and today I'm going to show you how to complete a cosmic trial with the space rat. Ha 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 ha! Whoa, 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 whoa! He's laughing at me. Okay, it's a rocket raccoon, obviously not a space rat, but here we have it. Basically, what do we have here? We have equipment of two blessed artifacts. One is Amulet of Quiox, which basically mainly gives damage rating to summon powers and some health. The other is really not kind of relevant to the cause. Obviously, Blessing of Frigga. And Blessed Advanced Super Soldier Serum that gives defense rating, health, regeneration, health, and chance to actually heal you for 10% more. And yeah, if they both have Blessings of Frigga, the other two artifacts don't have anything. It's item grade 33 artifact Oculus of Ouroboros, which allows it to regenerate health when you hit with an energy power, which is this one. Oh, by the way, yeah, this artifact is actually not blessable at all, Mask of Doom. We've got two intelligence, which is important characteristic for Rocket Raccoon. I actually started respecting him more than just him being a space rat, you know. He's actually a really good summoner in this game. Anyway, and yeah, summoned ally damage is very crucial on this one. And brutal strike rating is kind of a cool. If you're wondering what's playing on the background, it is Hans Zimmer, Amazing Spider-Man 2, original soundtrack, The Electro Suit, created with the Magnificent Six, I think. So Hans Zimmer and Magnificent Six basically created it. Anyway, what do we have for a medallion? I just used some level 45 medallion of Sabertooth just to give a bit of health regeneration, just make him a bit tougher. The Neptune Strident, not fully upgraded yet, but it will be hopefully at some point. The Fire Barrage, obviously her Uru Forge item that gives you energy damage rating. And I put damage rating for energy as a blessing. The ring basically gives you health when you defeat an enemy and extra plasma armor here, basically like mana. And I did upgrade the uniques to levels 69, so I got to admit that. And I used one, I think only two, I blessed two of them with damage rating to summon powers, and the rest I just used, I think, specific or random challenge bonuses. Obviously, the insignia of Rocket Raccoon is on Rocket Raccoon. Speed Cosmic Spirit. Normal costume. Flourish, you don't really care about. Not fully upgraded pet that gives you stash access card and it has plus 1 to all attributes at the moment. Let's do it! And here's where the music starts. Cosmic Trial. So basically I'll show you the loadout after I complete it, because it's actually pretty simple. I partially took it from a what's it called, from a guide online, and partially customized it myself a little bit. Basically, I'm fighting as a summoner, as you can tell, probably just putting turrets everywhere. And at the moment, I'm doing quite a good job. Three turret powers, one my friend Groot power. I'm not gonna use the ultimate, because, well, Link is actually not doing much anyway in this case. And shoot and run is kind of a power to get away from combat. case you're about to be nuked or something. So yeah, let's get rid of these robots quickly. We still have 3 minutes 40 something seconds, and that's plenty of time for us to defeat them. And the boss that appears afterwards, you probably know what it is. It's obviously Madam Hydra, wherever she is, there she is. Just keep spawning in the turrets and Groot and dodging away. That's what I did. Basically, I just click A as D, and right mouse button to dodge it. Sometimes I click H because it's my signature power for the area, and that's how I do it, really. Now, at some point, the shielding guy will appear. That basically puts a shield over Madam Hydra and keeps it on her. I'm just gonna concentrate the fire on him at that point. Obviously, the primary attack I'm using is Porter Minigun. And now that he's appeared, see, I'm just concentrating the fire on him. Briefly use the signature there where he's standing. He's not too far away from Madam Hydra, so technically placing turrets in this area will actually attack both him and Madam Hydra once the shield is gone, so yeah. Keep spawning turrets, keep dropping Groot on top of her. Mask of Doom creates some extra force that obviously start attacking the Groot with all their damage. Sometimes I recharge the plasma armor. And there we go, 1 minute 40 something seconds left. Well, I actually defeated her. Pull some turrets straight away for the next wave. Shoot these guys. Keep shooting at someone no matter what, because basically it restores your HP. Remember that bonus? Yeah, choose a target and shoot. If you're hurt, just heal with the med kit, basically. And rinsing the pool, basically. Not much else to do here. Still got 4 minutes something. That's plenty of time to defeat all these guys. And the boss that appears next, you obviously know who that is. Oh, here. From the first Avenger. Maybe. Not too much. Okay. Time to do a bit of signature. Get more turrets. That's where the last robots come in. They actually put a target on you, making you a bit weaker to their attacks. So you need to dodge. Sometimes fly off on the jetpack. Here's the Red Skull, the actual boss. Dodge, run away, heal, rinse, repeat. If you run out of bullets, wait for recharge again. Keep placing turrets. Just keep spamming button no matter what. Run away. Place more turrets when you come back. Now the signature. And here's the big bad robot. What is here? Oop. Did a bit of damage there. Using all the powers I can. And back to the Red Skull. We still have 2 minutes and a little bit left. So let's use it. just the same way we actually used it before. Oh, another robot, okay. Fair enough, rinse and repeat. Okay. Yeah, yeah, you got me. I got a shield though, so... Yeah, I'm lucky. Keep spawning turrets. Rolling back, shooting from all directions. Drop Groot on him. Roll up. Keep attacking with the left mouse button. The primary attack. And here we almost had it. Yep. That was it. We actually completed the cosmic trial in 1 minute and something remaining from the time. So now, as I promised, I'm gonna show you the loadout. Basically, I used some very popular guide of a summoner to do it. So basically, we have I'm Groot. Basically, the ability that applies some buffs while I'm in combat and stuff. Then we have upgrade our turrets, upgrade time dilator, upgrade plasma rifle. So basically all the tactical upgrades like which I've been using like all the bows here. And upgrade ghost rifle to make the turret, blast turret, fire heavy ghost rounds and increase damage and some sort of stats of it. Yeah, this one is actually getting upgraded because of the last talent. And yeah, obviously I'm using the photo minigun that is now basically called like that because I chose... I think this? Or this? I don't know which one basically. But basically one of these is... yeah, this one. This one. It's basically using only 7 plasma ammo and it's actually doing quite a bit of good damage and it's single target damage but it's perfect for bosses. The turrets, you know, like the blaster turret, suppression turret, time warp turret, all the upgrades are here. My friend Groot, obviously, another summon. Shoot and run. I wouldn't advise this one as much, just get away in the Cosmic Trial or in Cosmic Midtown, where there are many, many enemies. Obviously, like the signature and the rocket dash just allows you to dash all around. Infinity system, you wanna have a look? There we go. Hero synergy system, I just pick like mainly random ones. Obviously the Rocket Raccoon one is essential because it actually gives you the summon power damage of 10% in total. And just some random ones, other ones. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching and good luck with your cosmic trial. Oh, by the way, just as an added bonus, this is actually what the ultimate is for Rocket Raccoon. And it's not like very helpful because like you get transformed and you can't really use any of the other powers. Just this thing. But yeah, you have it for some time and then he appears back, but he has a really small recharge on the melee movement and you don't have to wait for it to replenish the charges, like the green charges here. So yeah. Like here, you actually have to wait for it to go all the way back to the maximum number of charges. So yeah, thanks everyone for watching again. This was Victor's Venue 360. See you next time.